Division viol, harp, theorbo, and violin, so we hope you really enjoy it. unusual ensemble, but it was very common at the court of Charles I of England, who was a great supporter of the arts and a terrible king. And unfortunately, these two artists we're featuring today, Henry and his younger brother William, were both tied up in the events that happened during his reign, in the civil war that followed, in which he more or less brought about. And then afterwards, after the monarchy, during the interregnum, when Cromwell was in control, things changed, and we'll talk about that a little bit later. But what you need to know today is that Henry and William were amazing composers of their time. There's a lot of great music that's out there, not just the sampling we're playing for you today, but we hope this little sampling will sort of spark you to get into their music a little bit more. Henry Laws, we're going to do a song by him next, was praised by his friend the poet John Milton, that's the Milton of Paradise Lost, as being the first English songwriter to set English to music in a way that rivaled the Italian masters of the time. In other words, Italian is a very beautiful language to sing. It's got a lot of pretty vowels and things. English is a little bit harder. He was considered to be the sort of the first Englishman to master that. So, a song by Henry Laws first, and then one by his younger brother William, and then another one by Henry.
I see there's no relief. and to those roses blushing on thy cheek, those lilies and those violets were seen to wither thus, till all the sweet we seek in our own way. I could never begin to court thee without hazard. These relics I adore, my flames increase, although thy beauty wears, and in this temperate season love thee more than in that scorching heat that went before, than in that scorching that went before. How happy art thou and I, that never know how to love, there's no such blessing.
Now we're going to move on. We're going to play some more of these harp concerts. That's really wrote for the court of Charles I. And these would have been done as part of state occasions. The pavin, you heard of pavin already, you're about to hear one now, was a slow, stately dance that basically everyone, no matter how young or old you were, could be able to dance because it had, there were no jumps or leaps in it, it was easy movements. And then after that, the almain, which is originated in Germany, faster dance in 4/4, and then the courante and the sarabande, which are basically Frenchified versions of dances from other countries before that.
Thank you. Thank you.
Psalmist the Humble God, is from the Sophie, written by a royalist poet named John Denham. It's a tragedy, and it's also kind of propaganda for the royalty. It's sort of a royalist play, pushing the sanctimony of royalty and things like that. Despite that, it's a good song. After that, there's a funny song from a silly play, a comedy called The City Match, that came out in 1638. And The City Match is basically about a woman named Penelope Plotwell. It's a silly sketch, plot, but she's poor, but she's trying to present herself as a rich woman to get married, to get a husband. And at one point in the play, one of the characters gets drunk. His friends dress him up as a giant fish and then display him in the fish market. And so that's, we show a monstrous crocodile. A little humor from 1638 there. And then a really great song called I Burn after that. And then another drinking song after that.
Songs by Henry Laws.
Sing, Lord, I
Let's see.